Hey guys, Etalyx here, and welcome back to Scrap Mechanic. I want to do some building today with you guys, because I was watching some of the older trailers for Scrap Mechanic from many moons ago, and I saw something the developers made that inspired me. I want to see if I can make something similar to what they made, because they have all sorts of cool creations, because they're devs and they know how all of these systems work intimately. We're starting with just this frame. It's got a little driver's seat, it's got a front thin pole sticking out where I want a wheel to go and a couple wheels in the back. We're going to make a trike, kind of like a motorcycle but with three wheels instead of two. And I want to have the front wheel turn by itself. Now there's an inherent problem with that. We're going to be turning in a very different way. Let me go ahead and show you an example of what that might look like. And yes, I'm pretty much going to make the entire thing out of concrete blocks. The reason is not because I love concrete, but because I don't have time to decorate right now. There's so much tearing down and building up from scratch that trying to put down some decorations that are inevitably going to get destroyed is not really worth my time. Now for this front wheel and all the wheels, I guess, we're going to be using the large wheel, and for that we need extra space. Look at how much this is already overlapping. So let's build out at least one more, see if we have room just yet. Very close. Do I need to go a fourth block? Really? Okay, and I want to lift this up as well so we can get underneath it. So we can lower the block back down by at least one. So the problem here that you might already be noticing is the redundancy. We can only use one bearing for this wheel. Unfortunately, you can't hook a bearing onto the other side of the wheel. It's just not going to connect. So this is ultimately what we're going to be stuck with, support from one side. You may also notice that I've got a little bearing here attached to the steering column. The purpose for that, as we thud back down to the ground, I think I could move this one back to the right, we'll do that here in just a second, is when I turn left or turn right, it kind of just tilts the tire a little bit. It's not going very far in any one direction, is it? One simple wheel is on, and we need two more in the back for support, and of course, so it doesn't just scrape along Flintstone style in the back. And it's going to be more in-depth than just chucking a couple of rockets on here and saying, "Woo, look how fast it goes!" I've got some systems in play in the form of these little wings. You'll see what they're for after we get these extra wheels attached. Okay, let's have the other wheels start by going up here, and I want one... Maybe we could fit them both on the inside. Wheels are, what, two apiece? Yeah, that's a little bit too tight. They're going to be rubbing all up against each other. So let's do this a little bit differently. We're going to go backwards, a few spaces. Again, we need at least three blocks for the wheels to be able to sit there in the middle, right? Of course, we don't have a bearing or anything like that yet, and I want some suspension for these because we don't need to have each wheel doubled up. We don't need two blocks on either side of it. We just need one. So with that in mind, let's try to get some off-road suspension back up under here. We're gonna need to lift up the whole frame one more time. And we don't need these to turn. I mean, you probably could get these to turn for a little bit of extra maneuverability, but I've got a different idea for maneuverability. And with the springs in place, we just need to get a couple of bearings, one on either side, and then the large tires should have enough room. So if I put them on the inside, this is the problem we would be running into. We got a cool-looking Batmobile here, but the tires would just friction against each other and everything would go wrong. So let's see how that suspension works for us, okay? Might need to be a little bit tighter suspension. The Sport may be a better alternative than the off-road. Let's try that instead. Taking on kind of a weird shape, isn't it? I don't know how well this is going to work. Let's go ahead and hook the tires up to the motor. Now, I definitely want the front tire hooked up to the motor. Why? Because with front-wheel drive, with the wheel turning, it's going to give it a little bit more agency when steering the car. So I don't know if I really want these back two wheels to be powered at all. Let's jump in. Okay, I must have this on the lowest possible power. It's on the fifth one. Let's just go up to like 8 out of 10. We're getting a little bit of speed, but can we do any turning whatsoever? We're just gonna get completely stuck here, no big deal. Our car may be slightly too long. We're gonna be clipping on the grass this whole time. Okay, front wheel needs to come down a little bit, duly noted. But the turning radius, look, I'm holding as far right as I can go, and this is as fast as we're turning. This is not gonna do it for us. We are going to need to make some fine-tuned adjustments here The tire should now be lower by one, which means that much extra clearance, not hitting every single hill on the terrain, making the ride that much smoother. Now, for the problem of turning. The front wheel turning by itself is not good enough. That's where thrusters come into play. And these little wings are going to help us get there. So hopefully these wings are far enough out to the side. Let's see if we can make this work. I want to try putting a bearing here, and then a concrete block on the other side of that bearing. Same thing on the opposite side. We're just mirroring this on both. Now what? Okay, you can now have a spinny block. Good for you! No, we're actually going to attach these up to the steering wheel so that when we turn, they turn. Now, what good is that going to do us? Well, let's add another block here and see what happens. Hit left, hit right. Okay, that's a good start. We've got a wiggly, waving arm car, but we got to take it one step further. More bearings and more blocks on either side. Okay, let's start with just two for now. Do the opposite, bearing, two concrete blocks. So now we want to go concrete up on both sides. And then we're going to attach our first thrusters. Planning on having, I don't know, two to three thrusters on either side. Let's go ahead and lock these into place so they stop just swiveling on their own. And let's try some rocket power now. A little bit to the left. Here we go. Okay, so what does this accomplish? If we spin left and right, one rocket goes down and the other thruster goes up. So let's give it a try. If I hold W, the thrusters are gonna turn on. We've got it set up to do barrel rolls right now, not turning. All right, so I see this still needs a little bit of refinement and work because right now all we're doing is just wobbling back and forth. We got simulated hydraulics here. They look so graceful, don't they? We just had to make a few modifications, a little tweak here and there, and I've already started. I brought the concrete block back by one, making kind of a backwards L here so they have more room to point up and down without getting caught on their bearings. And I also want to change the way that they point. So I want, when we turn left like this, I want the two thrusters on the right to be pointing towards the ground. Then I want the two thrusters on the left to be pointing up. So I need to do some reversing. I need to reverse the inside thruster on this side so that when we turn left, they're both pointing towards the ground. And I need to reverse one thruster, the inside thruster, on the other side as well. So now, they should be uniform. It may not be perfect, but I think it's time for test number three. Let's go. Let's try turning right first. Okay, a little, nope. Your heart's in the right place, Etalyx, but your brain's not. All right, so hear me out here. What if we attach the boosters to steer the car in the front of the car, ignoring the fact that this would completely demolish our first-person visibility, which we have none of anyway, thanks to how low I sit in this seat. Apparently, I am a baby. And then we put the boosters on the back like this. Also ignore the back blast that'll surely be hitting us in the face. We're pretty much immune to those emissions already. Then we gotta just make sure we can turn these blocks and activate the new thrusters from the driver's seat. So turn left, turn right. I mean, it could work, right? It could work. Okay, let's just, we'll never know unless we give it a try. So let's go forward. Pretty simple, turning right. Progress, a huge amount of progress. Yes, we rolled the car, but you also saw that we did successfully turn. And with a couple more boosters, we might be able to even right ourselves without having to worry about flipping it so easily. Maybe we need some extra railings or some wider wheels. Who knows? There's a lot of things to try out now that we're on the right track. That was definitely a step in the right direction. Now that we've got some kind of basic functionality down, I went ahead and added to that with some extra thrusters on top to help with that turn radius even more. And I've removed some of the ugly bits and added some new, nice, clean, rounded edges, which I would like very much to continue. I want to add a cockpit that opens and closes when you get into it. So I'm going to add a bunch of these little air ducts. And the reason for this is purely aesthetic. It's just to give that rounded shape all the way around the side of the car, kind of like this. Do the same thing on the other side. And now we get to start using the controller. This shouldn't be overly complicated. We're just going to make a little pod that opens and closes backwards and forwards if possible. The controller is sitting down right here. Now, we need a switch, of course, as well. So let's put that in place of the little air ducts we've been using. Doesn't matter where we put that switch for the time being, just because we just need it here for testing purposes. And there's two possible ways that we can go here. We can make a very stylish looking cockpit from the outside, so that you look at it, you go, wow, there's Racer X in there. Is he flying his new pod racer? Or you can try designing some stairs. And I am going to go the old stair route. I think it would be nifty if when you open up, it just pops down into custom-made stairs. I think we have enough concrete on this trike. I decided to use a new material. We've got small pipes here as our roll cage of sorts. And instead of fold-out stairs from the concrete, we now have a roll-out ramp. You can just walk right up, no jumping required. Hop in, and of course, close it back behind you. I've only done one half here, so I figured you guys might want to see a little bit more in detail of doing the other half and how to accomplish that. Step one is to begin with this row of concrete blocks here. I've already got a bearing so that when we attach this bearing to our new controller and tell it to roll 90 to the positive, let's go ahead and do that now since that is step one. We need to hook this up to the switch. That's going to be kind of annoying having the switch on the other side, but I think I can reach it from here. You can see that whole block is now going to roll with us. So now we need some pipes. This first pipe is just going to be facing towards the outside, and here's the trick. The bearing is hidden by the pipe. So we're going to have this done on both sides, I believe. We have another pipe facing this direction and another bearing hidden away inside of it, and then we just keep zigzagging upwards until we're ready to use the small length of pipes. We only have to use one, and then we're going to use another bearing, so there's almost one in every single pipe. Then we want the pipe splitter. Let's see if I can get that to face the correct direction as well. And do we have one there? No, but we do have one on the very tip top before we angle over towards the middle. The problem appears to be that each one of these blocks is leaning inward, probably because I have not yet attached this up to the new controller. So let's give that one more try if it'll stop spitting us out of my own car. So we had, what, two links of small pipe that way and two links this way. And again, we just need to hook these up to the brand new controller to make sure that they are perfectly taut. Okay, crisis averted. I was really kind of nervous there, not gonna lie. All right, how do we do this other piece? Looks like one length of short pipe, one to turn it downwards, and then two lengths of short pipe underneath. And we're almost there. Now that we've got both sides mirrored and looking pretty snazzy, we gotta study the side that we've already fixed so that I can mirror it on the other side. I've got a little bit of it going, and I'll show you what I've got. We need to spin everything outward except for the top two. Okay, duly noted. So what do we got over here? Let's take a look. I've got the concrete block rotating, and then I've got the bearings inside of these little corner sections countering that rotation so that everything remains vertical. And we want 3 and 6 to spin outward. So we need to go out red for 3, and then 6 is therefore going to be blue. So let's find 3. It's going to be going red. 6 is going to be going blue, and now when we attempt, we should see the first spin. Good. Okay, then we need to start having everything roll up, right? Which means that for the second animation step, the 2 and 5 blocks need to not counter the roll anymore. They need to just go outwards. So I'm going to do a little bit of tweaking and see if we can get this looking nice and pretty. 2 goes to red. 5 goes to blue. There's the roll, but at the same time, of course, we need all of these to be rotating inward so they don't get stuck on the ground. So 6 needs to go towards the red and 3 needs to go towards the blue for the second step. 6 towards the red and 3 towards the blue. So this is only going to have 3 phases at the most. I think it might be 2. At the same time, 4 and 7 are going to be rotating inward. So 4 needs to go red and 7 needs to go blue. And we have this very unnecessarily convoluted means of getting everything back flattened out. It's just really to look fancy. There's no other reason. And then we want the final tilt for the ramp. 5 to go blue and 2 to go red. So these are going to be very short 45 degree angles. And with that, we should see the ramp mirrored on both sides. Hop into the driver's seat and close her up. Nice and safe. Ain't that fancy. Unfortunately, I've had to tear off a lot of the back of this car. We still don't have enough clearance, do we? Two more thrusters going in right on top of the front two for that extra little bit of speed. And I do need some more decoration here to the back, but I think that I've done my job letting you guys know how you two can make this assisted turning mechanism. I really wanted to focus on that the most. Let me lower the lift here. Show you how you can use bearings not just for cool fold-out stairs or ramps, but also to help you turn your vehicle. And this is going to apply also to aerial vehicles, which is a little bit beyond my comprehension at the moment. So let's see how it rides now. We're a little bit light. Since we're purely made out of concrete, I stripped all of the steel. So we don't really have that attachment to the ground that I desire. So let me try adding a little bit more of that and we'll have the final ride of the Valkyrie. I am feeling pretty good about our final product here. Decorated a little bit more, added some more juice on the back, weighted us down with a lot of steel and metal to make sure we don't go flying off into the sunset quite so easily. Our fancy smancy ramp proving unnecessary as I clip right through it in my hurry to get back behind the wheel. Thank you guys so much for joining me here on this little build along. Hopefully you found some inspiration for something you might be able to create, or else get a little bit more in-depth look at the game if you're just tagging along vicariously playing through me. That's perfectly fine too. Got a couple more bigger projects in the works in Scrap Mechanic, whether or not they'll ever see the light of day, yet to be seen. Because they're really complex, and so far I've been failing miserably at bringing them to life. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did and you want to see something in particular, let me know down in the comments below. Thank you for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.